My goal was to train a machine learning model which would help me identify fragrance combinations which have a tendency to become popular. And since I did not have my own data set, I went into AWS Data Exchange and looked for a retail data set product. And I came across this retail data set package from Vertical Knowledge, which had data from Bath & Body Works company. Bath & Body Works sells a lot of fragrance products, so potentially I'll be able to use this data to train my machine learning model. So I subscribed to the product, and then I exported the data into an S3 bucket. And once data was in S3 bucket, I spun up this Jupyter notebook in order to perform some data analysis and feature engineering. So you can see that I opened this particular file and I looked at the different columns it had. I loaded the data into a pandas data frame and I dropped all the columns which were not relevant for my problem. So these are the columns which I ended up retaining. You can see that review count, average rating and lasted for. These columns can definitely help us understand whether the product became popular or not. So I analyzed these three columns and I created this rule in order to combine these three columns into a single label column. If the product has pretty good number of reviews and all the reviews are like pretty positive, and if the product lasted in the market for a long time, then it's a popular product. So you can see how I took this data and formulated my problem as a binary classification problem. So after doing that, my data set looked pretty simple. It had a name column, it had category column, and it had label column. So I decided to do further feature engineering on my data set. So I created this new column called length. I also did some basic cleansing on the name column. And I also created a new column called subcategory, based on the common suffixes in the name. So after doing a little bit of analysis, I thought that the data was in pretty good condition. So I decided to generate embeddings for my data in order to map the name column into a feature vector space. And you can see that each name was mapped to a bunch of numbers. And since the algorithm which I wanted to use actually required all the variables to be in numeric space, I think I was set with everything that I wanted to do. So now that my training data set was in the format which is accepted by the algorithm, I went ahead into AWS Marketplace, and in this case I ended up using Decision Forest classification algorithm from Intel. However, I can also use any other machine learning algorithm which can help me solve this tabular classification problem, including built-in algorithms from Amazon SageMaker. Next, I loaded this data into S3 and I specified hyperparameters and I trained a machine learning model. You can see that I got out-of-bag error of 0.299. which was not bad for my particular use case. I can also potentially tune the machine learning model, but for my today's demo, I simply decided to deploy the machine learning model which I had. And then, after I had deployed the machine learning model, I used the test data set which I had kept aside in order to see how good the machine learning model is. And you can see that I got the accuracy of 70%, which was not bad for my today's demo. So I went ahead and I did a little bit of analysis to see how the machine learning model was responding. For example, when I specified this particular name as the product name and this particular category, the model told me that the product is not going to become popular. So you can see how this machine learning model was able to extract patterns from this third-party data from Vertical Knowledge in order to train a machine learning model which was 70% confident, and this is the model which I can potentially use for making smarter decisions. So despite not having any of my own data set, I was able to go into AWS Data Exchange and identify a potential data set that I could use for solving the problem at hand.